I'm quite new to Python, but I already know that I'm going to want to install Python correctly so that I can do things like easily switching between different versions. So to show you how to install Python correctly, I've got a brand new system here. This is a fresh install of Ubuntu. And I'm using Ubuntu because if you're using Windows, which a lot of people are, then the Windows subsystem for Linux should allow you to do exactly the same steps. If you're on macOS, then you should be able to do very similar things through Homebrew. What I want to try and avoid are common gotchas, really, things like the system version of Python. So a lot of systems come with Python installed, and this one's no exception. In fact, for Ubuntu 20.04, it's Python 3. So here it is. So that comes with the operating system, but I don't want to use it for development. And this is what the OS needs in order to be able to run various Python applications. And I don't want to change that and mess about with that. But one thing that I will do is change the system so that I can use the regular Python command line. So in this case, I can just do sudo apt install. And there's a package called Python is Python 3. Now, if I install that package, then I can just use regular Python command lines, like this one, Python minus V to give me the version number, which is 3.8.2. On macOS, quite often it's version 2 of Python. Version 2 is no longer supported, so please don't use that for anything serious. You know, that's the operating system's Python. So I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to use the operating system's version of Python. The other thing that I could do is go to the Python downloads and simply download an installer for Python and use that installer to get me the latest version, which is 3.8.5. But I'm not going to do that either, because if I want to swap between versions quickly and easily, then I've got a problem. I have to uninstall the Python that I have and reinstall a new Python, and switching between those environments is not going to be particularly easy or comfortable. In Java, if I wanted this feature, then I'd probably use something like SDKman. But SDKman doesn't work with Python, doesn't let you install Python. But there is an equivalent in Python land called PyEnv. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to install PyEnv, and then I'm going to use PyEnv to install versions of Python for me and switch between them. So here I am at my command line. And I can install PyEnv by running a script that I can get from the web. So if I do curl https pyenv.run, and then I simply pipe that to bash so it will run it straight away. Then here we go, it's now installing PyEnv and a number of very useful PyEnv plugins for me. Okay, it's done that, and to finish the installation, there's a manual step for me. I need to copy these lines into my bash rc file so that when I start a command line, I automatically have PyEnv looking out for Python commands and directing them to the versions which I have installed. So let's do that now. Go down to the bottom here. Literally just paste that in. Okay, that's done. So now if I restart the command line and do PyEnv help, should show me that PyEnv is installed and here's the help. So that's good. When you install Python with PyEnv, what it's actually doing is it's building Python. So it's using the source code from Python and it's going to build it. And that probably isn't going to work straight away on this machine, because I'm going to need some other libraries in order to do that build. But let's check. We can use PyEnv to check. So if I do PyEnv doctor, it will check the state of the system for me. And there, problems detected. So I know that I need to install some additional libraries, and I'll show you where to find those. So here I am in my browser, and I've opened the PyEnv project page on GitHub. There's the address at the top there. If I look in the wiki, then if I just scroll down a little bit, it explains here the suggested build environment. So these are the tools that you need in the background in order to be able to perform a build. Because I'm on Ubuntu, I'm going to copy this command line here, and I'm going to run that on my terminal. And I can install all the necessary packages just using apt as normal. So now that I've installed all of those additional packages, I'm going to run the PyEnv doctor again, just to see if my system is now fixed and ready to go. Yes, congratulations, you're ready to build Python, so I'm good to go. Let's check which versions of Python PyEnv already knows about by doing PyEnv versions. It tells me I've got the system version, which we talked about earlier. I'm going to install the latest, which is 3.8.5. So I do PyEnv install 3.8.5. This will take a few minutes. It's going to download the Python source code, build it locally, and then make it available on my machine. Great, Python 3.8.5 is installed now, so let me show you how to switch between versions. If I do Python version now, I get the systems version of Python because that's still the default. If I do PyEnv versions, you can see that. So that is set to system. Let's now switch it so that globally the whole system uses 3.8.5. To do that, I do PyEnv global and then 3.8.5. And now if I do Python minus V, I get 3.8.5. So that's it, done.